today we are going to start our discussion about rest. So you will tell me when the time will be 20 minutes before. So last 20 minutes part of the
talk. Today's discussion will be in the midterm?
No. Okay. Not this one. Okay. Because already finalized everything. So today's discussion is not this. So today we are going to start our discussion about process. What is a trust? What is a trust? How
it's
do you define it?
Made of
members connected.
It's a shape as a rectangle, triangle. It's made up of steel or
members are connected by pin joint.
Which
makes triangle shape.
Make triangular shapes. Any other thing?
And the load on the pins.
Basically, it is a structural arrangement. It is a structural arrangement in which line members are connected by
pin joint.
Okay. Line members are connected by pin joint and loads are applied only on the joints. Okay. So basically, truss is a structural system in which line members are connected by pin joints in such a way that triangles are formed. Triangles are formed in such a way that they make the shape of triangles and loads are applied on and loads are acting on joints. So basically we have first condition is it is a structural system, right? Truss is a structural system in which line members are connected by pin joints. So members are line member and they are connected by pin joints in such a way that they form the shape of triangle and loads are acting on joints only. Right? If any of thing is not going to be satisfied, then it is not a triangle. Okay. For example, okay. If this is a triangle, knowing that all joints are pin joint,
yes.
If this is a truss,
yes.
Okay. Now if I apply load over here, now what it is? Its action is not a like truss, okay? Because load is not applied on the
joint.
Okay, so load must be applied on the
joint.
Over here. For example, this member is absent. Now, is this is a truss?
No.
Again, because it must form a shape of
triangle.
So all members they are connected in such a way that they form the shape of
triangle.
Okay, then. How the load is resisted in trusses? Okay. The load. The loads are carried, or the structure. More precisely, I can say structural action. For trusses, structural action means how structurally it acts, okay, or how it carries the load, right? Structural action for trusses is structural action for trusses is trying down.
Joints
on. Okay. Second is, what will be the structural action? The?
Humbal are connected by joint.
Now the second is, load are applied on the joints only. Second is,
the internal forces.
Members are subjected to axial load only.
Yes.
Right? So members are subjected to
axial.
Members are subjected to axial loads. It means either there will be a
tension or something.
There will be either tense axial tensile force or axial compressive force, right? And the loads are mainly resisted because of the triangular shapes. Okay, and loads are mainly resisted because of triangular shapes. Now its explanation is, can you understand? The load is mainly resisted because it is in the shape of
triangle.
The members are connected in the shape of triangle. Suppose, to understand this thing, suppose we have each type of strips. We have the strips, okay, and this is like masra,
yes.
Okay, like a ruler, okay.
Okay.
Right. We have the strips. So you have four strips, right? Two over here, and then the other two are over here. Basically four rollers, right? That's right. And we are placing them like one here and one here. Okay?
Okay.
So we are placing four. And we are inserting like a small one nail over here. We are just making a pain joint at this point. What is meaning of pain joint? So these two, they can, so here I am inserting a pin, right?
Mm, yes.
And they can rotate easily like this.
Yeah.
Is it?
Yes.
Okay, now if I take this one, like this, right, and apply some load over here, what will happen?
Rotate.
Mind it, these three one, right? So this is one, and this is second, right? Okay. And I am inserting a pin over here, like a nail, okay? And it can easily rotate, okay? So now I have one, two, three, and four. So these are the only arrangement, right?
Yes.
If I apply some load over here, what will happen? It will
collapse.
Yes.
Is it?
Yeah.
It will easily collapse. Now what I can do, so when you apply the load, it will collapse. Okay. So now I am going to add one more member. Fifth one. Okay.
Yes.
So I am going to apply it, for example, over here. So I am going to place one more, like roller over here. Now when we apply the load, what will happen? It will resist. It is stable, right?
Yes.
What's the reason?
Triangle.
The reason is because previously it was a square, right?
Yeah.
Now it is changing to rectangle. So triangles. Okay. So now it is changing to triangles. Now it will resist the load. Either you will apply in this direction, in this, but load is must be applied on the
joints.
So here, this one, right? Initially, these are like, you know, the red color, right? These red color, okay? Color bars are forming, are not forming, are not forming the triangle, right? Are not forming the triangle, is it?
Mm.
And the arrangement cannot carry the load. Okay. By adding another member, right? By adding another member, as shown in figure, right? The triangular shapes are formed. And it can take the loads. Mind it, the most stable shape, right, in structures is triangular shape. Okay. Triangular shape is assumed to be most stable shape. Okay. So what is the basic shape of a triangle? Therefore, the basic shape of triangle is shape of a trusses is a triangle, right? Means this is the simplest truss, is it? So load will be applied over here any direction. So this is the simplest truss. Clear? Then, next is the analysis of truss. Okay. So we use two methods for the analysis of trusses, right? One is known as
method by joints.
Method of joint, other is known as method of
section,
right? You have strategy.
Yes.
So the method for the analysis of truss we have two methods, right? One is method of joint, and then second one is method of
sections.
What we do in method of joint? We consider each joint separately,
mm-hmm.
and find the internal forces, is it?
Yes.
So in method of joint, we consider each joint separately and we try to find the
internal forces,
okay? In method of section, what we do? We pass a section, right?
Yeah.
And through the members where the forces are required. Okay.
Yes.
So we pass a section. At desired location. Okay. Desired location. And find the internal force. Very simple. You have already practiced it, is it?
Yes.
Okay. But anyways, we will solve certain problems to see into these matters. Next is type of trusses. Okay. So next topic is we have different types of trusses based on the material, based on the use, based on the shapes. We have different types. Okay. So based on material, we have wooden truss, means a truss made up of wood, steel truss, sometime clear, we have the wooden truss, we have the steel truss, and then we have the LGS. What is LGS?
Light gauge steel.
Right? Light gauge steel. Okay. Then based on the type, based on use of the truss. Okay. So based on use of, so based on use, basically we have two types of trusses. So one is known as roof trusses. And the other one is known as bridge trusses. Means the trusses which will be used for the construction of houses, right?
Mm-hmm.
That will be the roof trusses, and that those which used for the bridge construction, they will be bridge trusses. Okay. Next, types of trusses based on the shape of truss. Mind it, for specific shape, we give different names. Okay. For example, and again, we have the shapes for the roof truss, and we have different shape for the bridge truss. Okay. So we have different shape for the roof truss, and we have some shape for the bridge truss. Okay. For example, and the employed members will be it, this is the shape of the truss, and it is for the roof, right? Okay, this is known as prod truss, PRAWT. The name of this shape is
roof.
This is known as prod truss, right? This is name of the truss from the name of a person. Okay. Then if similar prod truss we make it for bridge, its shape will be like this one. Now this is the prod truss, right? It is used for the bridges. Okay. Why we need this type of shape for the roof trusses? Because usually we use the trusses in the areas where the snow is expected, right? We want to make the sloping roof. Okay. But in case of bridge, snow is not an issue, right?
Yeah.
It don't have the cover,
yes.
Is it?
Yes.
So, do you know where the traffic will go? On which location? It is going on this direction, is it?
Yes.
No. So you are, it is over here, right?
Yes.
So your car, it will be passing over here.
Yes.
Okay. So your car direction will be maybe over here. So this is the position where the car goes. Exactly like this one, yes. Okay. So this is the position in which it will go, right? And the roof, here we will place the shape. So similarly, we have different shapes. Okay. And I am going to show you these shapes now. In your book, there are several shapes, right?
Look, sir.
Yes.
How I make sure that the load is applied on the joint? For example, there will be a wind load, and the wind load, for example, will not be acted on the joint.
In case of roof trusses, right? Yeah, in case of bridge trusses.
Any case.
In case of bridge trusses, the wind load is not important. Reason is because it is open, okay? Wind will pass through it, very small load, right? As compared to its load, its own weight and live load and dead load, it's not an issue. Here, we have to make such arrangement that loads are applied only on the joint. Okay? And inshallah, we will discuss it, that how we make sure that load is applied on the joints only. It do not go on the members. Okay? So we will discuss it in detail. Similarly, we have another very interesting type of truss for the bridges, and it is known as K truss.
Red color.
This is known as K truss. Why it is K? Can you see it is making a word K over here, right?
Yes.
This one? Is it?
Yes.
All are K. Over here these are opposite, is it?
Yes.
So this is known as K truss. Again, it is quite famous for the bridges. Similarly, we have another type of truss. It is known as Warren truss. Actually, it has two stalls, right? So I am going to show you these examples when this is going to start, right? Okay, I will show you this one. Meanwhile, we can start our next topic, because here I will show you only fringes, right? Okay, so assumptions for the analysis of trusses. So when we are going to analyze the truss, we make certain assumptions, right? And the first one is the members are connected by smooth pin joints. Loads are applied exactly on the usually what is meaning of pin joint? That two members, they can rotate easily, right? But if you see the actual truss, then it is not like that. Okay. Now in actual trusses, these are the two members for the truss, okay? Right? And then we are going to place like a plate over here. And then we are going to fix fix these member on the plate. And you understand what is this here?
Yes.
So this is one member, this is another member, right? And for example, this is the shape of this joint. Is it? This joint. So this horizontal member and vertical member at one. Okay. So to join them, what we do? We place a plate over here, okay, and we insert the bolt more than one. Right? So all these members are free to rotate?
No.
So we assume it, right, that our members, they are connected by smooth pin joint. Okay. And this assumption is correct. Valid. What is the reason? Reason is because in all the loads are applied on the joint. Okay? There is nothing like bending action is absent. It is not there. There is nothing, there is no force which creates the bending. Okay? So therefore, even it is connected like this one, right? Stretch, its action is exactly like the pin joint. Okay? And the second is loads are applied exactly on the joint. So we find the center line of this one, and we find the center line of this one. So this is the point on which we assume the load P will be. Okay. So these are our two basic assumptions. First one is the members are connected by smooth pin joint, and then second is loads are applied exactly at the center of the joint. No, it's not fixed. That's what I want to tell you, right? So, in case of, even you weld it, right? And you will see the trusses, right? So, they are welded over here, right? They are welded over here.
Yes.
You, what is welding?
Lam
is made, right? It's different, right? Okay. But anyway, so it's like a welding, right? But even you fix it properly, right? So, it will... Its action is exactly like the smooth pin joint. Okay? And that's why I am saying it as assumption. Okay, so next one is I am going to show you these pictures and then, okay, then we will start a problem. This is chapter 3, can you see? So our discussion will be about the trusses. So here are different shapes of the trusses, right? This is chapter 3 and figure 3-3, okay? And mind it, these are the shape of roof trusses. And this is example of a house with roof truss. What is this truss? Can you tell me? What is the name of this one?
Prat.
Prat. Prat.
Right? It's easy because you can see vertical member and then diagonal member. Okay. So this is prat truss, a good example. Okay. So here we have different names, right? Pali trusses. For example, this type of truss is also there, which is known as Caesar truss. Okay. This one is known as hoe truss. H-O-W-E, hoe truss. Right. Then this is a prat truss which I just sketched for you, is it?
Yes.
So this one is known as fin truss, fin truss. Okay. Then cambered fin. Okay. Do you know what is meaning of camber? Camber is this shape.
Yes.
Okay. The hugging shape,
the hugging
is camber.
Right?
So cambered shape. This is warren truss. Okay. Then next one is the sawtooth. Do you know what is sawtooth? What is saw?
Saw?
Yes. Saw? Yes, yes, to cut it, right?
Yes.
To cut the
wood.
So it's teeth, right? It's exactly like this one, is it? So the teeth of the saw like this. So saw to trust, right?
Mm-hmm.
So that's what its name is. Then bowstring. This is bowstring trust.
Yes.
What is this bowstring?
As
hogging.
I don't know. Course.
Yeah.
Course.
Like an arc. Like enough, right? So I don't know how to say it in Arabic or in English.
Bow, of course.
No. I know the course is there, right?
Yes.
But
yeah.
Bowstring. What is bowstring?
String. It's as a
yes. It is just sometimes they use for hunting, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So there is. This is like a curved, cool
yeah,
shape.
Yeah.
Here is a string, right?
Yes.
Okay. And like a rubber. Okay. And then they put an arrow over here, stretch it, and throw it, right? That is bowstring. Okay. So this is bowstring art, and this will be 3-inch art. Okay. 3-inch art, okay? This one, last one is
3-inch.
Yeah. So, but usually, out of all these shapes, the most common shapes are these two, the prat shape and the warren truss. These two shapes, these are very common, okay? And listen what I say. So if you want to make fully flat slope, right? And sometimes we also use hoe truss. Okay. So when we want to make fully full slope, right? Means zero slope at the end, maximum in the middle, we go for these two options. Okay? And can you see what is the difference between them? This inclined bottom, it is same, right?
Yes.
Vertical members are same, is it?
Yes.
Only difference is these inclined are from here and this inclined are here.
Mm.
Okay, other is same, right? Parallel. Here is parallel, right? So this is just the change of the diagonal shape, okay? And then in this one, the diagonals are alternate.
Mm.
Okay, so basically, we use 1, 2, and 3 shapes. If we want this shape, either this one or this one, and if we want, do not want zero at the end, zero height, okay, we need some height at the end as well. So we go for this shape, okay? And interesting thing is, it is easy to make, okay? So this shape is very easy to make. Sometimes we omit this vertical member there, okay?
Yes.
Okay, so this is small introduction about different types of truss, right? Okay, so please try to remember at least name of some famous trusses, okay? Because sometimes it is asked, is it?
Okay.
So it is asked in the quizzes. For example, this shape is given, what is the name of this truss? Or the name is given, sketch this truss.
Okay,
so with this one, let me close this discussion over here. Next class, we will discuss about the coplanar trusses, then determinacy and indeterminacy of trusses. Okay?
Okay,
so...
this shape's only for roof, right?
Yeah, these are roof trusses, right?
Mm-hmm.
I am not discussing the bridge trusses, right? So I am just discussing this one, roof trusses. Okay? So here we have all these shapes, from A to F. Okay? Clear? Okay, so now, for the tutorial, right? I will answer whatever questions you have. I think it's more easy, right? Do you want to solve some problem? Which one is easy? I think you have not started studying structures, right? So maybe
no.
you don't have the question.
No,
is
it
started?
Yes.
That's good. So, okay. So let's solve certain problem. Okay. And in this, so you can start with this problem. And over here there is one movement is acting, right? So this movement is, by example, 50 kilonewton meter. And these lengths are, this is also 5 meters, and this is also 5 meters. So, very simple problem. Okay? Can you solve it?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, try it. Okay, let's see what will be your answer. Okay? So, if you need any help, I will help you, right? But you need to solve it individually. So, first thing is, you find the reactions. What will be next step?
Separate
into member and joint, but in a proper way. So here is a common mistake, right? And I am telling you, if you will repeat it in the exam, your mark will be reduced. And that common mistake is, so student, what they do, they draw this member over here, this joint over here, this member over here. Doesn't make sense, right?
Yes.
Only you need to separate, increase this distance, increase this distance. Okay? Right? Okay, so this point is A, B, and C.